Hindus believe in reincarnation. Each rebirth is determined by the karma that you accumulate from your previous life, but it can also be affected by Hindu notions of purity. But there is a sect of Hinduism called the Aghori, challenging the very fabric of Indian society. Most Hindus are obsessed with maintaining ritual purity, not eating certain foods or touching certain things that can defile you. What this obsession with purity and pollution has done is it's created what we now know as a caste, from the Brahmin who are at the very top to what we now refer to as the Dalit, or the untouchables at the very bottom. It's the untouchables who do all the work that nobody else wants to do. They're the ones who clean the streets, pick up the garbage, deal with the sewage, things that would defile a pious Hindu.
When body is burning, if anybody get this access in his body, power is coming from there.
The Aghori believe that God lives within you, and if God lives within you, then nothing you do can defile you. A very small movement, mostly of ascetics, prove this belief by taking part in ostentatious displays of defilement. They will cover themselves in the ashes of the dead. They will eat rotted corpses. They will drink their own urine.
Oh my goodness.
They will sleep within the cremation grounds. It's an idea that's very difficult for everyday Indians to take part of. But something remarkable has happened over the last few decades. More and more middle-class Indians, Brahmins even, disgusted with the caste system in India, have begun to adopt Aghori ideals, but through social activism, by taking care of the weak, the hungry, by feeding and caring for the poor, by touching those who are outcasts, the lepers, the sick. And they do this from a place of deep spiritual awareness. They really believe that God lives within every individual and that nothing can separate you from God. It's a beautiful idea.